Good evening. Tonight I'm going to try a chain pour, and I'm going to try it on this background that I've just taken. I poured some different colors of paint and just kind of spread it out with a brush, and I've let it dry. So now I'm going to try doing a chain pour on the dry and see how it works. If it doesn't work, then I'm going to try putting some pouring medium down. Give it a shot and see what happens. Okay, so it's not going to spread like it does when there's wet underneath. You can see that right now. You'll notice how it's pulling instead of spreading. Okay. So this is actually Demco pouring medium. I should actually wipe that off and start again, because I think I'm going to have to spread out some medium. So I'm just going to wet it and wipe that off. And then I'm going to spread a little bit of pouring medium down. Just gonna spread it out. I'm gonna put one there. I'll just put a thin coat, because it will give kind of a shine to the. And I probably got too much. Might as well give it an all even coat. And I do like playing with my hands. I don't know, sometimes, for some reason, getting your hands dirty just feels good. But I can see to pull, we need kind of a wet background. Basically, I'm just spreading out this clear pouring medium, Demco, just to give myself something to pull through. That's all I'm doing. There's a chunky. I think this will work. I think you need something wet to pull through. I just think that's the way it's got to be. I'll wipe my lid and get that lid on, because that's where you get those little hard crunchy things around the neck of it. Pull in. And now I'm going to try again. I think it'll pull better now. Then again, you get a different effect. It's actually really cool. Let's see what we can do. See, now that pouring medium obviously gives it that breaking that you get with silicone. It's kind of cool, too. We'll see what it looks like when it's done. Where did I put I'm always moving things out of my way. There it is. Nope, that's not it. Let's make another. Looking for my little fork tool, but obviously I misplaced that yesterday. I'll have to make another one. Okay. Yep, a completely different effect. Way different. Whether this bronze is going to show up in there, I don't know. I guess we'll find out. Hey, I like that. I got more paint on it that time. You know, I always figure, what the heck, the worst you can do is scrape and repaint. But it's floating on there a lot more. That's kind of amazing me. So there's much more floating going on. I'm not sure where to go with this. Go where your mind tells you, right? Let's see, and to pull one up there. Pull the leaf in there. Painting with chain this time. Why not? Who says you can't? Anybody that says you can't haven't tried it yet. Sorry guys, I keep getting lost and then I forget to talk to you. But I know what I'm trying to do now. I'm trying to get these kind of feathery leaves in here. I'll get it. Just keep trying. Afraid to try. That's the worst that can happen. But, yep, to get the proper effect, you do need a wet background. So, you can use pouring medium, but be aware that you will get, obviously, breaking up just like you do with silicone, which I wasn't expecting. I really wasn't. Painting until I like my end result. And I think I'm going to put another one over here. Whether I'll like this or not when it's I shouldn't say that I like it, because it's different. And who doesn't like something different? I do. Oop. Could be more paint up there, because I want to bring that one in taller. Oop, and I like a great big bubble. Just keep fixing it until it's the way you like it. And I think I can pick up those few little bits, but I will try here in a sec. If not, you make them work. You make it fit in. Like that. I think I'm just going to try bringing a little bit more gold in at the points. I think now that it's had a chance to sit up, maybe it'll grab a little bit there. Give a bit of a definition on the edges. You know what? Everyone's a little different, and there's something you're going to like about one, and something you're going to like more about another one. I'm just going to bring a sharp point onto these leaves. See, it's already had a little bit of a chance to set up. So this will make it a little bit more defined. It does get a cool effect though, guys. You know? Let's just say it's right or wrong. Different. And you know what? I've always found it's great to be different. Everybody's painting look the same. It'd be pretty boring, wouldn't it? Guarantee you when you do something like this, nobody's is going to be the same as yours. Nobody's is going to be the same. I'm just not sure. I think it needs just a pop of yellow at the center of that flower. What it needed, but that's what I did. It's really going to be interesting to see how this dries. It really is, guys. Whether it'll end up being too transparent. You know, it's hard to see how it's going to dry. Sometimes the bronze or the metallics can dry quite different than from when you put them down. Can't they? And as we've all found out. Just trying to give a little bit of a definition to the edges of those. Because they've sure sunk in. To each other. If I can just pull a little bit in. Find that edge. stand out a little bit. Petal per petal, anyway. Sure, I'm enjoying doing these with you guys, and hopefully, as you're watching me mess up, you learn something too. It was interesting though, Kathy, because yeah, I think it was Kathy, I'll have to look. Dry did not work. Anyway, I think I'm going to leave it right there. If I think if I try to get these little specks off, I'm just going to cause more issues than I had before. I got a feeling anyway. Anyway, if you like this video, if it gave you any ideas at all, that's awesome. Kind of spreading out that gold a little, so, or bronze. Maybe it looks more like a shadow than a mess up. I'm not careful. Anyway, I'm going to leave it alone before I mess things up bad. So, please like, share, and subscribe, and hope you enjoyed the video, and thanks for watching.